Good evening, and welcome to our virtual production of House on Haunted Hill. I'm Mikey Dearn, and I'm the director of tonight's performance. What you're about to see is an adaptation of the 1959 William Castle film, which was written by Rob White and has been tailored for virtual production. The group you'll see on here tonight consists of theater enthusiasts that have that had another show, Dad's Dance, which was scheduled to go back up in March, but I'll talk about Dad's Dance more at intermission. In the meantime, we remain a group of actors who love theater, we miss theater, and we hope that this little performance of ours brings some spooky entertainment to you for about an hour or so during this Halloween season. So, get comfy, turn out the light, and enjoy House on Haunted Hill.
The ghosts are moving now. I can sense them. Restless. Hungry.
What? Excuse me. Are you Miss Madea Pritchard?
Yes.
And you are the current owner of Price Manor, more commonly known as the House on Haunted Hill?
Yes. It's the only really haunted house in the world, you know. Since it was built over a century ago, seven people, including my dear brother, have been murdered in it. And since then, I've owned the house.
Well, Miss Pritchard, I'd like to finalize the details of renting your house for tomorrow evening. As I mentioned to you in my letter, my name is Frederick Castle, and I'd like to rent your house for one night so that my wife can throw a party, a haunted house party. Isn't she amusing? Well, there'll be food and drink and ghosts and perhaps even a few murders. You, of course, are invited to attend as well, Miss Pritchard. I think you'll find the incentive quite compelling.
And that is?
I will give anyone who survives until dawn $100,000.
$100,000? And how many other guests will you be expecting, Mr. Castle? And how will they be arriving?
Four others, and they'll be arriving in separate funeral cars.
Funeral cars?
It was my wife's idea. She's got quite a dark sense of humor. But who knows? After a night on the House on Haunted Hill, they might have a few bodies to load. First, there's Lance Shewster. He's a test pilot.
Oh, he must be a very brave man.
Well, don't you think you could be much more brave if you were paid for it? I know Lance needs the money, and if he's brave enough to stay the night, he'll earn it. Next, there's Ruth Bridges.
The woman who writes the column in the newspapers?
Yes, she says she wants to write a feature article on ghosts. She's a compulsive, no, dare I say, a degenerate gambler, so I know she's desperate for the money. Next, we have Dr. David Trent. He's a psychiatrist, and he thinks my ghosts will help him with his work on hysteria, but I can't help but sense a little greed in him. Finally, there's Nora Manning. I chose her out of the thousands of people that work for me because I know she needs the $100,000 more than most. She's very young, and she supports her entire family.
Mr. Castle, I think I will take you up on your offer to join the party tomorrow night.
Well, now, the more the merrier. You can arrive with the other guests 1 hour after sunset. I will send a car for you.
Thank you. I'm not keen on being in that house, but I also happen to need the money.
Before we end this meeting, Miss Pritchard, I must ask you one question. Have you ever spent the entire night in that house yourself?
I only spent one night there. And when they found me in the morning, I was almost dead.
So this is Price Manor.
Very big. And rather spooky.
It isn't a very warm welcome, is it?
Only the ghosts are happy that we're here tonight.
Well, nobody's here. No host to greet us.
Are we all strangers to each other? Don't you two know each other?
Me? Oh, I'm Nora Manning.
Lance Shewster.
And you?
David Trent. Dr. David Trent. And you, my dear?
I am Ruth Bridges.
From the Boston Globe?
Well, it appears we have a celebrity at our party.
Oh, I'm flattered, but I'm hardly a celebrity. Tell me, is Frederick Castle a friend of yours?
I've heard of him, but I've never met him.
I work for one of his companies, but I've never seen him.
I've never met the man either. Just a phone call. Do you know him?
No.
Then you must be the only one of us who does.
Me? I don't know him. I only met him yesterday while confirming the details of renting the house. Everything else has been done by mail.
He's quite wealthy, isn't he?
Multi-millions or in the billions?
And five wives.
Four, I think, so far.
$500,000 party for five people. Well, it seems a little steep, well, even for a millionaire.
Well, if I was to haunt anybody, this would certainly be the house that I'd do it in.
Who closed the door?
It seemed to do so all by itself.
I can't get it open. This thing is made of solid steel.
Oh, you know, that chandelier doesn't look very sturdy.
You're right. It's about to fall.
Nora, look out! Are you all right?
Yes. Yes, I am, thanks to you. If you hadn't pulled me out of the way, I would have...
Then you'd be one of them. I tell you, the ghosts are already moving.
Annabelle, our guests are here, and fortunately still alive. Is your face on yet?
Dust and dirt everywhere, and the water barely trickles. Shouldn't you have had the place cleaned?
Well, you know how ghosts are, darling. They never tidy up. As attractive as that nightgown you're wearing is, it's hardly suitable for a party.
I'm not going to the party.
This spend-the-night ghost party was your idea, remember? And it's costing me $500,000, so I want you to have fun.
The party was my idea until you invited all the guests. Why all these strangers? Why none of our friends?
Friends? Do we have any friends?
No, your jealousy took care of that.
I had a reason for inviting each guest, but they share one thing in common. They all need money. Now, let's see if they're brave enough to earn it.
And you call this a party?
Could be, but no party is complete without champagne. And I just so happen to have some here on ice.
Why do you always have to shake up the bottle? It's
afraid it, champagne. Afraid it might explode?
It never does.
Would you guarantee that?
Frederick, that isn't funny, pointing the cork right at my head.
That would make a hell of a headline, wouldn't it? Tycoon kills wife with champagne cork. Have it your way. Will you join me as I pour?
No, thank you.
Oh, A sip might improve your humor.
My humor is fine, thanks. And I haven't poisoned it.
Always good to know that. Here, have some. You'll enjoy the party more. Cheers.
Your trust is so touching. And I'm not going to the party.
You know, of all my wives, you're the least agreeable.
But still alive.
Would you go away for $10 million? Tax-free?
Only 10 million.
You want it all, don't you?
I deserve it all. Your jealousy isn't tax-free, and your possessiveness is maddening.
If ever a man had grounds for divorce.
But can't prove them.
Oh, you'll slip up one of these days.
Think so?
If I live long enough. Do you remember the fun we had when you poisoned me?
Something you ate, the doctor said.
Yes, arsenic on the rocks. And you'd do it again if you knew you could get away with it, wouldn't you, Annabelle? I hear hanging is quite uncomfortable, in case you get any more ideas of how to get rid of me. I'm going downstairs to greet our guests. Don't let the ghosts and ghouls disturb you, darling.
Darling, the only ghoul in the house is you.
Look at these wall decorations.
These paintings are bound to give me nightmares.
And look at this thing over there. It kind of looks like an oversized, you know...
knife!
Miss Pritchard, what are you doing with that knife?
This is what she used on my brother and her sister. Hacked them to pieces. And we found parts of the bodies all over the house, in places you wouldn't think to look. The funny thing is, the heads have never been found. Hands, feet, and things like that. But no heads.
So there are two loose heads, just floating around in here somewhere.
Listen, you can hear them at night. They whisper to each other and cry.
I don't hear anything.
Good evening. I am your host, Frederick Castle. Since we're all strangers to each other, why don't we get acquainted with a drink, shall we?
Mr. Castle, I advise you to call this party off now. The ghosts are already moving, and that's a very bad sign.
Let me apologize for my wife's temporary absence. She'll join us in a little while. What will everyone have?
Dry martini.
And for you, sir?
I think I'll have a scotch on the rocks.
Now, before we begin the party, let's go over the details, shall we? The caretakers will leave at midnight, locking us in here until the morning. Once the door is locked, there's no way out. The windows have bars any jail would be proud of, and the only door to the outside locks like a vault. There's no electricity, no phone, no one within miles, no way to call for help.
Like a coffin.
So if any of you decide not to stay for the party, you must let me know before midnight. Or, of course, if you leave, I won't be able to pay you anything.
No, I'm interested in your reasons for this party.
Ghosts. I think everyone wonders what they'd do if they saw a ghost. Now my wife has given us the opportunity to find out.
Ghosts are nothing more but the creations of hysteria.
Oh, Miss Pritchard here promises us genuine ghosts.
Seven now. Maybe more before morning.
That's cheerful.
Three men have been murdered in this house, and four women.
planned your party well, Mr. Castle. Three of us are men, and four of us are women. Well, there's a host for everybody.
Now, Miss Pritchard, why don't you take us on a tour of the house, and we'll see what happens.
Follow me. Look above your heads. See that stain on the ceiling? That's blood.
How on earth did it get up there?
A young girl was killed here, and whatever got her wasn't human. Oh, don't stand there!
What do you mean, where? Oh, something dripped on me.
Oh, they've marked you.
Oh, ridiculous. The roof probably leaks.
That must be what it is. Who would want to haunt me?
Here, I have a handkerchief.
Oh, thank you.
I hope it doesn't come back.
Oh, well, Miss Pritchard, you are the life of the party.
She hasn't even started yet. Wasn't there a man who threw his wife into a wine vat or something?
Oh, that was in the cellar. There's been a murder almost every place in this house.
Well, one could open their own winery with all this equipment.
Now, this is my kind of room.
All of this stuff belonged to a Mr. Norton, who did a good deal of experimenting with wine, but his wife didn't think it was any good. So he filled a vat with acid and threw her in. This one, to be exact. She was supposed to stay down, but the bones came up. It's a funny thing. None of the murders here were just ordinary. They've all been sort of wild, violent, and different.
Nora, don't get too close.
Yes, you wouldn't want to fall in.
You mean there's still acid in there?
Oh, yes. Here, let me show you. Doctor, there's a rat trap behind that table. Would you get it for me, please?
Let's see. Oh, my. That's a large rodent. How did you know there'd be one in there?
There are always rats down here. Go ahead, drop it in the acid. See, it destroys everything with hair and flesh, but leaves the bones.
How grotesque. I think I need another drink.
Plenty upstairs. Come on.
Let me just close the vat.
Nora, wait. Before we join them upstairs, tell me, how did you get invited to this party? What did he tell you?
Mr. Castle said everybody would get $100,000.
But he didn't say anything about being locked in.
No.
You believe in ghosts?
I don't know. You?
I believe in what that doctor says. You can spook yourself. I've done it in planes, seen things that really weren't there. Or were they? Anyway, what are you going to do with your 100,000 if we get it?
What do you mean, if we get it? Won't he pay us if we stay?
Oh, I'm sure he will. That kind of money to him is no more than what pocket change is to us.
My family and I were all in a car accident, a hit and run drunk driver. I was the only one in my family who wasn't severely injured by the accident. So now I'm the only one who can make us any money.
I'm sorry to hear that. Say, how many doors does this cellar have? I've never seen so many. Looks like a closet in here.
Uh-oh.
wine bottle storage in this one. I can't really see what's in this one. I better take a few steps in.
Well, does it go anywhere? Lance, the door! I can't get it to open! Lance, can you hear me?
Double, toil and trouble. Fire burn and cauldron bubble.
What is that? It's floating! Oh, Lance, please come back!
By the pricking of my thumb, something wicked this way comes!
Lance, there's a ghost!
Eye of newt and toe of frog, wool of bat and tongue of dog!
It's gone! It just floated away! Lance, can you hear me? Help! Somebody help! Help! Please help!
What is it?
Yes, we heard shouting.
Lance is stuck in this room and there's a ghost.
A ghost?
You know what I mean.
Maybe we should break down the door. Oh, it's locked.
It seems to be open now.
Lance, are you in there?
Yes, I'm over here. I'm gonna need some help getting up.
Well, here, take my hand.
Are you all right?
Nothing that money won't cure. Oh, I must have bumped my head.
But this room is completely empty. The only way you could bump your head is to, well, run head on into the wall.
You didn't do that, did you?
Let's get you back upstairs.
I wonder why they didn't kill him.
Who?
He didn't bump his head. They hit him.
Sit down, Lance. Mr. Castle, do you have any bandages or medical supplies?
No. Mr. Slydes, are you up here?
Yes, sir. Is everything all right?
Everyone, this is Mr. Slydes, the caretaker. Mr. Slydes, one of our guests has sustained a minor injury. Is there a first aid kit in the house?
Oh, dear. Yes, I believe there's one in the kitchen. I'll go retrieve it for you.
Thank you.
Nora, when you were calling for us, you mentioned something about a ghost?
There was something.
What did it look like?
It was wearing a long black dress that went all the way to the floor. It had the face of an old woman with snarly white hair, and it was floating.
You were a little frightened at the time?
Well, yes.
That, Mr. Castle, is hysteria.
Then, Doctor, how do you explain what happened to Lance? Was that hysteria, too?
Here's the first aid kit. Now, Mr. Castle, I'm going to do my nightly rounds. It's about an hour to midnight.
Thank you.
Well, Lance, let's clean that wound up.
Oh, thank you. Much obliged. Nora, wait for me in the hall. Grab a candle.
The ghosts are coming closer.
You really believe in your pet ghosts, don't you?
Before the night's over, you will too.
Would you like a drink while the doctor patches you up, Lance?
No, thank you.
I'll take one. Scotch and soda, if you please. Mr. Castle. Are you really, really going to pay anyone who stays all night?
Certainly. $100,000.
Will there be much red tape or delay?
In a hurry, dear?
Frankly, yes. Or frantically.
Here's your drink, Miss Bridges.
Thank you.
There now. All cleaned up. You better get that looked at in a couple of days.
Thanks, Doc.
I have the candle. What is it for?
We're going to see what was really down in that cellar.
Oh, Lance, I'm not so sure I want to go down there again.
I'll be with you this time. Don't be afraid. Here, I'll light our candle. All right. Okay. Now, here's the room where you all found me. Someone or something was in here when I came in, but where? And if the door was locked, how did it get out? What you saw might have been a ghost, but what was in here with me, well, that was no ghost.
I don't know. I was just so scared.
There's no other way out. It's just this door and solid walls all around. Does that sound different to you when I knock on the wall?
Yes.
Okay. I'm going to go over to the next room and I'll knock on the other wall. You stay here. And when you hear me knock, you knock on this wall, okay?
Okay.
Try knocking in a different place.
Oh, I'm not so sure I want to be down in here anymore. Lance, is that you behind me?
Hark, villain! I will grind your bones to dust, and with your blood I'll make a paste, and with a coffin it will rear.
Lance!
I'm back. I'm here.
I saw it again.
Well, where is it?
It floated out of here just before you came in.
Well, why didn't I see it?
You don't believe me.
Well, it's just I didn't see
You know
see
what? I'm going back downstairs. You can find whatever hit you by yourself.
Nora, wait!
Are you all right, honey?
Who are you?
I am Annabelle Castle. You must be Miss Manning. Would you like to freshen up?
Oh, yes, please.
This way. This is your room. Depressing, isn't it?
I doubt if I'll be spending much time in here.
It's about to storm. Perfect atmosphere for my husband's party. Nora, why did you come here?
He said he'd give me $100,000.
Why did he pick you?
I don't know. My supervisor came in and said I'd been invited.
How long have you known my husband?
I just met him tonight.
Don't go anywhere in this house by yourself again. Now fix your face, and I'll come back for you in a few minutes.
But I have...
You are in danger. We all are.
By who?
I hope for your sake you never find out.
Oh, hello there. I didn't see you in the dark.
I'm Annabelle Castle. Were you looking for something?
Not exactly. I'm Lance Shewster.
The pilot. Oh, I see you've hurt yourself.
No, it's nothing. It's just a bump on the head. Which one of these is my room?
I believe this is it over here.
Oh, well, thank you, Mrs. Castle.
You were with the young girl in the cellar. Why was she so upset?
Well, Nora thought she saw a ghost, and I didn't see anything.
She was just frightened then.
And mad at me. I think I kidded her about it.
I wouldn't joke about anything else that happens here tonight. Lance, if I need help, may I count on you?
Sure, I guess so. Look, what's going on here anyway?
My husband is planning something.
Well, must be pretty big if he's willing to lay out $500,000.
Money doesn't mean anything. He has a reason for getting us all up to this dreadful old house.
What for? He doesn't even know us.
Maybe that's exactly why you're here.
Well, what can he get away with?
Oh, he thinks that big money like his can get away with anything. You know, of course, that I'm his fourth wife. The first simply disappeared, the other two died. Lance, I don't want to join them.
Wait a minute. You mean he had something to do with their...
Oh, his doctors say they died of heart attacks. Two girls in their 20s. My husband is sometimes insane with jealousy. Nothing matters to him then. He'd kill me if he could. Please be careful.
Of course.
There you are, darling. You're missing all the fun. Nora Manning was almost killed by a falling chandelier and the pilot bashed his head in.
Is he badly hurt?
Oh, the doctor bandaged him up. Why don't you go console him like you do most men in your fashion?
You are so clever, Frederick.
Well, you didn't marry me for my wit. Now hurry up, they're expecting us back downstairs.
Frederick, for the last time, I am not going to your party.
And for the last time, it's not my party, but yours. And you're going.
Get out, you're hurting me.
Are you ready, dear?
Yes, damn you.
Would you adore me as much if I were poor?
Let go of my hair. I said I'm going.
Fine. It's almost time to lock up the house. Then your party will really begin. I wonder how it will end.
Who is it?
It's your host, my dear. I'm letting everyone know we're meeting in the living room. It's almost midnight.
All right, I'll be right down. Now that I've washed my face, I should get my makeup out for a touch.
What is it?
There's a bloody head in my suitcase! Mr. Slydes, how'd you get into my room?
Never mind that. Now listen to me. You need to come with us right now.
What?
You'll die if you stay. Come with us before he kills you!
Take a short intermission now, and I'd like to take this opportunity to talk about Dad's Dance. Dad's Dance is a play written by Ed Humphries to be directed by Eric Hart. Both of them are in the show tonight. And we were scheduled to go up back in March. It's a very moving piece about love, dance, and the power of community. But unfortunately, like the rest of the world, had to be put on hold. But we decided to stay optimistic. We've been meeting on Zoom, keeping it fresh. But we hit another bump in the road. We lost our original venue, but thankfully, our friends at Gateway Players in Southbridge have graciously decided to add us to their upcoming season. And so we're very grateful to Lowell and Corkum and the rest of the board for giving us a place to perform it. And with their help, we'll be able to bring you Dad's Dance as soon as we can get the world back on track. We're hoping that this is our first of many virtual productions. Next up, we have The Lost World, which is another Ed Humphries original. It's been done a few times live, so we'll be doing that this winter. Hopefully, we'll get that underway soon. Many theaters, both professional and amateur, are now suffering the threat of permanent closure due to COVID-19. Since tonight's performance is free of charge, we ask that you make a small donation to a performing arts fundraiser. And there's a couple of suggestions on our Facebook page, on our event page. First, our friends at Gateway Players, the wonderful people that offered to put Dad's Dance back on the stage, they have an ongoing collection called Gateway to the Future. 3 years ago, for unforeseeable circumstances, they had to leave their home, the Gateway Barn, which housed their shows for the last 4 decades. So they do have a temporary stay at Elm Street Congregational Church, but they're looking to get a more permanent home. So if you'd like to donate to them, just go to their Facebook page, Gateway Players Theater. And at the top of the page is a big blue donate button. Just click on that and you can make a donation. The other fundraiser on our page is a relief fund for Broadway workers. As you probably know, Broadway has extended their closure to May of 2021. So that means all Broadway is out of work, and that's not just the actors. That is the technicians and the box office workers and the ushers. So this will this fund will provide a little financial relief to them. Their link is also on that page. And it doesn't have to be those fundraisers. You can make a contribution to any performing arts or any theater, large or small. Every little bit helps. And now we'd like to return you to Price Manor for Act Two of House on Haunted Hill.
Most of us are here.
It's getting close to midnight. I'd like to begin.
Where's Nora? Miss Manning.
I don't want to stay here.
Nora, what's happened?
Mr. Castle, it's quarter to midnight. I think it's time to collect my wife. Has anyone seen her?
Out, brief candle. Life is but a walking shadow.
That's the ghost! That's the ghost I saw in the cellar!
That's no ghost. That's Mrs. Slydes, the caretaker's wife.
I'm so sorry if she disturbed any of you. In addition to being blind, my wife also has dementia. She wanders around the house reciting Shakespeare. She used to teach, you know.
It's a vile thing to die, my gracious lord, when men are unprepared and look not for it.
I have her now. I'm going to go set some more traps. Come along, my love.
Good night, sweet prince, and flights of angels sing thee to thy rest.
Lance, I'm not going to stay here.
Doctor, it looks like we have a genuine case of hysteria on our hands.
I think she's just a little upset. I'm not hysterical.
Good evening.
Hello, dear. This is my wife. Darling, these are our guests.
Charmed.
Lance, get me out of here.
But what about the money?
I don't care. He wants to kill me.
Who wants to kill you?
Mr. Castle.
May I have your attention, please? I think you all remember the bargain we made about staying all night. $100,000 apiece. If any of you don't survive, the money will be divided amongst the rest of you. If I don't survive...
Yes, dear?
You will be paid by my estate. When the door is locked on the outside, we'll all be forced to stay in this house until morning. If any of you decide not to stay, you must leave with the caretakers now. You won't have a chance to change your minds later.
I'm not going to stay.
It isn't midnight yet. Who told them they could leave?
Well, they never leave before midnight.
Well, they're gone now and we're locked in.
But I don't want to stay.
I'm sorry, but it looks like we'll all have to stay here in this house until 8 o'clock in the morning. But we have some party favors for you. Everyone, please take one.
Party favors?
Why are the boxes shaped like little coffins?
Open them. See what's inside.
A gun?
We all have one.
My wife's idea. I think it's rather dangerous, but in case you don't know how to use a pistol, you put your thumb and pull this lever here and then pull on the trigger. See? They're loaded.
These guns are no good against the dead. Only the living.
Go ahead, Nora. Take yours.
And here's yours, my dear.
I don't need one.
Oh, it was your idea. And who knows? Before this night is through, you may want to use it on me.
Throw these guns away. They won't do you any good.
I agree with Miss Pritchard, but, well, not for the same reason. I mean, Well, suppose Nora had a gun when she saw the Mrs. Slydes and mistaken her for a ghost.
I don't think anyone is going to walk around in total darkness.
Oh, I am sure we are not going to run around the house shooting at each other, aren't you?
Who knows? Fear makes people do amazing things.
Really, darling, I don't need mine. Please take it.
Miss Pritchard, you said your sister-in-law killed a man and a woman here and cut them up?
Yes.
You said they found hands and feet, but never any heads. Would you like to see one of those heads? Would you all like to see one of those heads? Well, then just come with me. Just go look in my suitcase. Just go look.
Nothing in here but clothes and cosmetics.
But it was in there. A woman's head.
Nora, I think you're a little upset. Would you like a sedative?
Get out! Get out of my room, all of you! Just get out and leave me alone! Just get out!
Do you think it's all right to leave her alone, Doctor?
Well, I wish you'd taken the sedative.
They're closing in on her.
Well, I think somebody ought to stay up here with her.
There could be a million people around her, and if they wanted her, they'd get her.
What if she's right?
I don't think she knows what she's talking about.
I wonder. I'll be in my room.
Do you think there was really a head in her suitcase?
I don't know.
If I saw a thing like that, I think it would put me right over the edge.
Yeah. Look, would you stay up here with her and just in case she needs help, Miss Bridges?
All right, I'll be in my room, keeping an ear out.
Thank you.
Mr. Castle, are you sure there are only 7 people in the house?
Except for ghosts?
I don't believe in ghosts, nor in frightening people. In Dora's case, I think it has gone far on too long, perhaps too far. Don't frighten her anymore.
Nora, I've come back to check on you. Are you feeling better? Nora, where are you? I've come back to... Oh, dear God. Oh, my God, Nora!
Lance, what is it?
What is that resting on top of that lamp over there? It looks like a head. A woman's bloody head.
She was right. They've taken her. And in a little while, she'll be one of them.
What do you know about this? Where's Nora? What have you done with her?
It's too late. She's gone. And there's nothing that we can do about it.
That sounds like that came from the foyer. Come on!
Oh, my. Oh, she's hanged herself.
Is it Nora?
No, it's Mrs. Castle, and, she's dead.
But there's no chair. No ladder. Nothing she could have climbed up on. If she didn't hang herself, how did she get up there?
Bring the body in here, Doctor. It's an empty room. Lie her down on the bed.
All right. Nobody else touch her. It'll be easier when the police come to investigate.
I can't believe Mrs. Castle hanged herself.
She didn't hang herself. The ghosts got her.
Oh, Miss Pritchard, please, not now with you and your ghost.
Look, one of us should find Mr. Castle and tell him.
Tell me what? I heard loud noises. Why are you all gathered in here?
It's your wife. She's dead, Mr. Castle. We found her hanging in the foyer.
A suicide? Oh, Annabelle.
You probably want a moment alone with her, sir.
Yes, of course.
Not to rush you out, Mr. Castle, but I think we all need to gather together to discuss what to do. The living room in 10 minutes?
Yes, I'll be there.
I'll meet you all downstairs. I'd like to know where Nora went.
Oh, Annabelle, my darling. Even in death, you look so beautiful. And somehow, still so greedy.
Nora!
Lance, over here!
Nora, where are you?
I'm here, behind the drapes. Lance, you need to hide me.
What are you doing over there?
Please, please hide me.
All right, in here. Nobody will look for you in my room.
He tried to kill me. He grabbed me, dragged me into the closet, and he choked me. And then we went away and he left me and he thought I was dead.
Who?
Mr. Castle.
Are you sure about this?
Well, it was dark, but it must have been him.
Has anybody seen you besides me?
No, I'd heard some people in that room, but I snuck by and nobody saw me.
Oh, listen, Nora. Mrs. Castle is dead.
Dead? But how?
Castle says she committed suicide, but I think somebody killed her.
Him?
Look, I have to go downstairs for a while. You just lock yourself in here and don't make a sound. Don't let anybody know you're in here. If he thinks you're dead, he won't come here. I'll be back as soon as I can.
Thank you, Lance. I will.
I'm leaving you the gun. If you have to, you use it.
Where's Nora? Shouldn't we wait for her before we start this meeting?
I didn't disturb her. I don't think this really concerns her.
Yes, I suppose you're right.
I can check in on her after.
No. I mean, I'm sure she's fallen asleep by now.
Well, in that case, let her rest.
Let's get down to business. Mr. Castle, is there some way, any way we can get out of this house now?
I don't believe there is, Miss Pritchard.
No, none at all.
Well, couldn't we try breaking out?
The only door to the outside is made of steel, and the bars on the windows are set in solid stone. We have to stay.
I am not afraid of your ghosts, Miss Pritchard, but I am afraid. We all came here a few hours ago. The only thing we had in common was the $100,000 we'd get. But now, however, we share something else. The death of Mrs. Castle. So far tonight, one of us has been almost killed by a falling chandelier. One of us was mysteriously slugged. And one of us been driven to the point of absolute hysteria. And now one of us is dead. Were these accidents? A suicide? And we must stay here for 6 more hours?
6 hours and 6 of us.
So, who will be next? How will it happen?
Let me ask you a question, Doctor. You were the first one to see my wife hanging there. Did you also see anything else she could have climbed up on and jumped from?
No.
Did any of you?
No, nothing we could see.
There was nothing.
How then did she get up that high?
Exactly, Mr. Castle. How? Well, she couldn't have pulled herself up there and dropped from the ceiling. You think she killed herself?
No. She was murdered by one of you.
Or you, Mr. Castle. To deliberately kill someone, you must have a reason.
We were all strangers to your wife. Only you had a motive for murder.
What husband at some time hasn't wanted to kill his wife? And what husband hasn't had 1,000 opportunities to do it in such a way he'd never be suspected? I am not fool enough to hang my wife from the ceiling by a rope in front of a bunch of witnesses.
The fact remains that you, or one of us, murdered Mrs. Castle. And that is a matter for the police.
But how do we get the police?
Well, that's my point. We can't until morning. What we began as a silly parting given by an eccentric has now involved us all in murder.
You know, for once, Miss Pritchard may be right. If another murder is in the works, let's stop it now.
What do you mean, another murder?
Why not? Maybe one of us saw too much.
Why should even a millionaire want to give us each $100,000 to spend the night in a gloomy old house? See some ghosts at a party? No.
Have you finished trying me yet, Doctor? And is the verdict guilty of murder?
Now, this isn't getting us anywhere. Somebody killed Mrs. Castle. We know that. One of us is guilty, and the rest of us are innocent. Now, what we have to do for the next 6 hours is protect ourselves from each other.
You really think that...
I don't think anything. I just know that I'm going to my room, and I'm locking myself in, and if anybody tries to come in, I'm shooting him or her.
And if we all stay in our rooms, we'll all be safe because, well, the innocent will have no reason to leave their rooms, and the guilty will admit their guilt if they does, he or she.
And we all have guns.
So, we're all agreed?
I'll go up now. No point in saying goodnight, I guess. Oh, I wish this night were over.
Rooms, guns. I tell you, it doesn't make any difference. They just aren't through with us yet.
Nora, I'm back. Are you okay?
Yes, I'm all right.
They've all gone to their rooms and locked themselves in.
Lance, I've been thinking. It was so dark when I was grabbed. Maybe it wasn't Mr. Castle.
Oh, it was him, all right. He tried to kill you, and he did kill his wife.
How can you be so sure?
She tried to warn me. She asked me to help her. The doc thinks he's going to try to kill one of us.
What are we going to do?
There must be some way out of this place. And I'm going to find it, and I'm going to get the police before he does.
Then I'm going with you.
No, Nora, he can't find out you're alive. You're safer here than anywhere else. After I leave, just lock yourself in and keep quiet. If I find a way out, and if he thinks you're dead, he won't look for you, and I'll come back and I'll get you.
I'll be waiting for you.
No. A house like this has to have more than one way out. But where would that be? I have to find it. Nora's counting on me. I didn't see that door before. Maybe it leads to an attic or a tunnel. Oh, I wish I brought the candle. I can't see a thing in here. Hey, who shut that door? Hey, now,
Hey, let me out. I can't get out. Hey!
That storm seems to be right on top of us now. Oh, Lance, please come back safe. If I get out of this, I don't even want the money. To see the sunrise in the morning would be just enough.
Nora! Nora!
No, I'm not hearing that!
Yes, you are, Nora. And you can see me, too. I'm standing right in front of you.
Mrs. Castle? But you're dead!
Yes, Nora, I am dead. I'm dead because of you. You should have helped me, Nora. You just let him kill me.
No, this is not happening!
There's only one way out. The cellar. You have to get to the cellar, or he'll get to you too, and you will join me. The cellar! Go! She's really moving, isn't she?
Really moving was your performance, my love.
You really think so, David?
Oh, yes. We've committed the perfect crime.
Get me out of this hanging harness, will you?
Of course, I couldn't be sure. I had to convince Nora to protect herself with the gun, but after I grabbed her and threw her in the closet, well, she thought it was Frederick, and everything we had planned began to work just as we planned. And then seeing your ghost, well, that sealed the deal. You were wonderful. It was just the perfect thing to drive her to absolute hysteria.
It'll be worth all of our planning, darling. Nora must be on her way to the cellar now.
She'll shoot the first person she sees.
And Frederick?
Oh, I'm about to send him to the cellar too.
David, are you sure none of them will suspect us?
Of what? An hysterical girl accidentally shoots someone? Who would suspect we'd planned a driver to it?
What about my suicide?
Ah, the claim was just a ghost party gag, and we'll say it was a dummy since I was the only one who touched you.
What about Nora? She's not stupid, you know.
Darling, believe me, there will just, you know, everything we planned is working perfectly. Nora's sure that Frederick murdered you. She thinks it was him that attacked her, but not me. And now she's almost out of her mind with fear. Well, the heads, the ghosts, you're hanging. I tell you, when Frederick walks in there, she'll shoot him.
David, you ought to be there when it happens. Make sure Nora finishes the job.
Yes, my love. Well, I'm going to send Frederick to the cellar now. I'll be right behind him, and when you hear the shot, come down and join us.
I will, my lovely.
Well, Doctor, shall I call this intrusion an admission of guilt?
Certainly not. Either someone else is in the room, or one of us has left their room. Did you hear anything?
Thunder.
Well, that and someone walking around.
I have my gun. Do you have yours?
Yes. You should look in the cellar and work your way up. I'll start here and I'll work my way down.
Why not together?
Well, there could only be minutes, perhaps seconds left in someone's life. But this will save time.
Yes, I suppose you're right. I'll start in the cellar.
Stop right there.
Nora, put the gun down.
Not even for $100,000, Mr. Castle.
Nora, no!
I shot him. I shot him!
Beautiful show, Mr. Castle, but I'm afraid it's all over. But just to be sure, how about a dip in a vat of acid. Now up and in we go.
David, where are you? It's so dark down here, I can't see a thing. Who did that? And what's that coming out of the darkness over there?
What's the matter, dear? Don't you recognize your own loving husband?
Frederick? But you're...
Dead? Of course I'm dead. Your lover threw me into a vat of acid. Now I am but what you see in front of you. At last, you have it all. Everything I own. Even my life. But you won't live to enjoy it.
Get away from me! Get away!
Come with me, murderess. Come with me. Just one more step and you'll join me.
I just knew this costume would come in handy someday. It really is scary, especially in the dark. You should have watched your step, darling. Now you've fallen into the vat yourself and joined your lover. Good night, Doctor. Good night, Annabelle. The murder you two planned was indeed perfect. Only the victim is alive and the murderers are dead. It's a pity you didn't know when you started playing your little game of murder that I was playing too.
Let me out of here! Help! Help!
We're trying, Lance.
I think if I can just work the lock like this.
You got it.
Oh, thank you. Oh, I thought I was going to be in there all night.
Lance, everybody, I shot Mr. Castle. He's down in the wine cellar.
Is he still alive?
I don't think so.
Oh, don't be so sure, Miss Manning.
You? But I shot you.
You didn't kill anyone, my dear. I loaded your gun with blanks. I can tell you all now that Trent and my wife were trying to kill me. They failed. Trent tried to throw me in the vat. I reacted in self-defense. I made my wife fall in too. I am prepared to let justice determine if I am innocent or guilty.
Now they're nine. There'll be more. Many more.
So it isn't over?
No, they're still not done with us yet. They're coming for us now. And the night is far from over. I can feel them. Restless. Hungry.
Oh, I can hear them now.
And they're coming for us.
We hope you enjoyed our virtual production of House on Haunted Hill. Now I'd like to present to you the cast. First up is, Kelly Dearn playing Mrs. Slydes. Playing Mr. Slydes, Sean Nault. Playing Ruth Bridges, Teresa Simpson. Playing Dr. Trent, Eric Hart. Playing Miss Pritchard, Lynn Boucher. Playing Lynn Shewster, Ed Humphries. Playing Nora Manning, Anjolina Fantaroni. Playing Annabelle Castle, Pritchard, Tiwari. And playing Frederick Castle, Stephen Jean. Thank you all for joining us. Have a happy Halloween.